हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल कवर आवर 1E एंड 1F। दे बोथ आर बेस्ड ऑन द एस्टिमेशन। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन हाउ टू राउंड ऑफ ए नंबर नियरेस्ट टेंस 100,000, 10,000। ओके, सो हियर वी विल यूज दैट रूल्स एंड वी विल find out the product and the division. The 1E based on the product, we have to do multiplication in this after rounding of the numbers, and in the 1F we have to do the division. Okay, so let's start with the first question of our first exercise, that is 1E. In this, the first question, first 5-6 questions are based on this statement. Estimate each of the following products by rounding off each numbers to nearest 10. Means in under the statements, how many questions are given, all you have to solve by rounding off that numbers nearest 10. Okay, so first we will round off these two numbers and then we will do multiplication. Okay, so let's start. What is given to us? This is given to us. Okay. So first we will round off 38. Okay. Where nearest 10. 38 estimated to nearest 10. Okay. What will be the value? We have to estimate nearest 10. So this is our 10th digit and it is 8. We just look at the digit immediate right to that. Okay, so here is 8, so we have to look at the ones digit, you can say. So 38, this is greater than 5, so it will be 40. Now we will estimate 63 estimated to nearest 10. Okay, so here 6, 10th digit is 6 and that is 3, less than 5, so it will be only 60. Now what will be our required estimation? Hence required estimation is equal to, we will multiply this because 38 is now 40 and 63 is now 60. So what it will be? 00 will be at the end, and now we will multiply 6 and 4, it will be 24. So our answer is 2400. Okay, now fifth question, number 5. Here we have to estimate the product of 64 and 50. So first we will estimate the 64 estimated to nearest 10. 64, we have to estimate nearest 10. So the ones digit is less than 5. So what it will be? It will be only 60. Yes, it will be only 60. Now we will estimate 50. 50 is already estimated. No need to estimate that. If you want to write that, you can write 50 estimated to nearest 10 is equal to 5 and that is 0. So it will be only 50. So now, hence our required estimation, hence required estimation, or you can say required product, okay, is equal to, multiply this 60 into 50. What it will be? 00 at the end and 6 5s are 30. So our answer is 3000. Now we will do question number 7 and 10. Okay, In the question number 7, we have to estimate the product. Estimate each of the following product by rounding off each number to nearest 100. We have to estimate in that nearest 100. Okay, so statement of question number 7 is here. That is 376 into 123. Question number 10. 509 into 170.
You can say 179.
So here we have to estimate product of these numbers nearest 100. So we'll start with question number 7. Okay, statement is this. 376 into 123. We have to estimate first this 376, estimate it to nearest. Here we have to estimate nearest 100. Okay, estimate this nearest 100. This is our 100th digit. So we will look at the immediate right to that, means at the 10th digit. This is greater than 5, so it will be 400, because they will be 0 and it will be increased by 1, so it will be 400. Okay, now second number is 123, estimated to nearest 100. Nearest 100. So this is our 100th digit. We have to take a decision about this. 10th digit is less than 5, so it will be only 100. No increment in that. Okay, now what will be our required estimation? We have to multiply these two. I told you when we have to multiply any number that contains 0 at the end. So what we will do? We can put that 0s directly in our answer. So here is 2 and 2 here, 40. Now what is left? 1 is left and 4 is left. Now multiply 1 and 4. 4 1 ja 4. So this is our answer. This is our answer. Now question number 10. What is the statement for that? 509 into 179. First we will estimate 509. 509 estimated to nearest. Here we have to estimate nearest 100. Yes. Now estimate 509. Nearest 100. So this is our 100th digit, and the digit that is at the 10th place, that is 0 less than 5, so it will be only 500. Okay. Now next is 179 estimated. I'm writing that estimated to nearest 100. Nearest 100. So estimate this. This is 179. 100th digit is 1. And the 10th digit is 7. So 7 is greater than 5. So it will be 200. Now we have to multiply this. Hence required estimation, or you can say hence required product. Okay. So you will multiply this. What it will be? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros will shift directly in the answer. Now you will multiply 5 and 2. That will be 10. So this is our answer. What is our answer? 1 lakh. What is our answer here? 1 lakh. Now we will do question number. Means the third part, in which we have to estimate the given numbers. Okay, statement is little bit changed, so I'm writing that rounding off in that we have to estimate one number downward and one number upward, then we have to find out the product. Okay, so how to estimate downward and how to estimate upwards? Here from question number 13 to I think 18-19, I have solved 13 and 17. Statement is, estimate each of the following product by rounding off first number upwards and second number downwards. Please understand this carefully. Okay, what we have to do in the upwards and what we have to do in the downwards. First, write the statement 30, that is 183 into 154. Next is 17, that is 680 into 164. Okay, so first we will, here statement is first number upwards, means we have to estimate first number. First is, this is our first number and this is our second number. So we have to estimate first number upwards and second number downwards. Okay, so write first number. This is the solution of 30. 183 estimated first number but upwards is equal to, upwards means we have to increase this digit. We have to increase this digit. We will not look at this. हम इनको नहीं देखेंगे, हम इनको देखेंगे भी नहीं. Just we will replace these digits with the zero and we will increase this upwards. Upwards means ऊपर लेके जाना ना हमें. Okay, we have to increase this. So it will be 2 and 0, 0. Okay, upwards. Downwards means नीचे. We have to decrease the level. So second number downwards. What is our second number? 154. Estimated downwards. Downwards means we will not decrease that. If we will estimate this, it will be 200, but we will, in the downwards, this digit will be same always and this will be zeros. This will be zeros. Hum inko zeros bana denge. Okay, so it will be 100. What I have done here, in the upwards, I'll increase this digit and remaining will be zero. That is 200. In the downwards, I'm talking about the greatest digit, means सबसे जो आपकी left hand side में digit है. So it will be as it is and these two will be zero. Okay, so it will be 100. Now what will be our required estimation or our product? You can see required estimation is 200 into 100 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros and 2 ones are 2. Okay, now the question number 17. First number, this is our first number, this is our second number. We have to estimate first number upwards and second number downwards. So 680 into 164, 680 estimated, where to estimate? Upwards. First number we have to upwards. So after estimation upwards, what it will be? We will increase this and this will be zero. So it will be 700. Okay. Now 164 estimated downwards. Downwards, we will not look at these digits. This will be same and this will be zero. So here will be 100. It will be 100. So what will be our required estimation? Hence, required number, you can say is equal to 700 into 100, that will be 70,000. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 0 you will write directly, then multiply remaining 7 into 1. Now, next statement means next type in this exercise is, it will be reverse, means estimate each of the following products by rounding off first number downwards and second number upwards. Okay. Now, first number downwards and the second number upwards. Okay, question number related to this is 90 and the 21. Okay, statement of 19 is 356 into 278. Okay, here is 578 into 369. I think this is 9. Okay. 369. We have to estimate these number upwards and downwards. Okay. Upwards and downwards. So, first number is downwards. So, this is our first. It will be downwards. This is our second. It will be upwards. Okay. First, this is our second. It will be downwards. It will be upwards. Okay. So let's start. Okay. Question number 19. Here, 356 into 278. Estimate 356. Estimated. First number downwards, estimated downwards. In the downwards, first digit will be as it is and remaining will be 0. So it will be only 300. Okay. Now, 278 estimated upwards. Okay. Upwards means it will be increased. So this will be 300. Hence, required number, or you can say required product. What will be that? 300 into 300. 4 zeros. 3 threes are 9. This is our answer. Question number 21. Statement is 578 into 369. First number will be downwards. So estimate 579. Estimated downwards. Downwards means first digit as it is remaining 0. So it will be 500. Now 369 estimated upwards. Upwards means it will be increased, so it will be 400. Very easy. Okay. Hence, the required number or required product, you can say, what is that? 500 into 400. 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now multiply 5 and 4. 5, 4 is 20. So what is our answer? Our answer is 2 lakh. Okay, now we will do our 1F. That is also very easy. Here we have done multiplication. In that we will do division. Okay. let's start. This is our 1F. Okay. 1E we have done. Now this is 1F. Okay. So in the 1F, find the estimated quotient for each of the following. We have to find out the estimated quotient. Okay. So first one is 87 divided by 28. What we will do? First, we will estimate this. Okay. So 87 divided by 28, put this in bracket, approximately equal to, this is approximately equal to, okay, approx, we are taking here approx. Approx means lagbhag, uske roundabout we are talking about here. So 87 divided by 28, this is one complete number, is approximately equal to, first round off this, we will round off here at the greatest place. So this is greatest place is 10, so we will round off this nearest 10. So 87 will be 90. Yes, divided by 28 will be 30, because the second digit is greater than 5, so it will be 30. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to solve only this. Yes. So what it will be? 90, you can cut here like this. 90 divided by 30. 0 to 0, 3 ones are 3, 3s are. So what is our answer here? 3. What is our answer here? 3. Now here I am taking fourth part. In that 193 divided by 24. First we will write the approximate value of this. So 193 divided by 24 is approximately 100th place, so it will be 200. It will be 200 divided by 24 will be 20, because second digit is less than 5, so divided by 20. So now do this, 200 divided by 20, so our answer is 10. Now question number 8, what is given to us? 729 divided by 29. Okay, first we will write the approximate value of this. 729 divided by 29 is approximately equal to, don't write this equal sign, equal to. So it will be equal to, at the, we have round of the 100, so this is less than 5, it will be only 700, and this will be 30. So here we have 700 divided by 30. 700 divided by 30. Now do this division. 700 divided by 30. 0 to 0. Now you will do this division. Okay, I am doing here 70 divided by 3. 3 2s are 6. Here will be 1 0. 3 3s are 9. There is 1. Okay. So when this is 1 only, when you will put point here and you will put 0, you will go further, 3's are 9. Okay. So after the decimal you are getting here 0.3. So 0.3, 3 is less than, after point whatever we get, we will look at that digit. This is less than 5, so it will be only 23. So what is our answer here? 23. Okay. If after point you are getting digit 5 or more than 5, then this number will be increased, or you can say last digit will be increased by 1. Now the 10th part. Is 8 6 8 6 8 divided by 38. First we will write the approximate value of this. 868 divided by 38 is approximately 8, and this digit is greater than 5, so it will be 900. 900 divided by 38 means 40. Okay, so what we have to do here? 900 divided by 40, 0 to 0. Now we will divide 90 by 4. 4 to the 8. 1 will be there. Yes, now take 0 here. 4 to the again 8. We are getting here 2. Now we will put point here and 0 here. 2, 5 are 20. So what we get here? 22.5. I told you, if you are getting after the decimal you are getting 5 or greater than 5, then this number will be increased by 1. So that means our answer is 23. Okay, so do remaining by your own. These two exercises are very easy. Okay, class, thank you.